Hey guys, today we are at the Preah Vihear temple in Cambodia and I found something very interesting and I cannot wait to show you this comb. Now, this temple was built in 12th century, right? So this is about like 900 years old and you can see these big blocks of sandstone. But apparently this is impossible technology, right? Because you see these huge blocks of stone. But look here, the corner pieces. Look at the corner pieces. You think these are, for example, two pieces of stone, but they're not. Look at the right angle. This is just one piece of stone. Or it may not even be a stone. It may be like a geopolymer technology because look, there's nothing in between, no connection. Look here. And then there are no connections. Look here, if you want, there is a spider here, so I may not be able to touch it. That's a huge spider. But look at the corners. Do you see any lines at all in the corners? No, this is one stone, apparently. What kind of technology is this? How did they make these corners completely using single stone blocks? This needs extraordinary engineering. Now, let's go on the other side to see what's going on. Look at this piece. Again, no connection on the corners. But look here. This is not even just like one piece. It goes all the way here and apparently bends. The stone's bending at an angle. It's curving. And then comes here, goes at a 45 degree angle, and goes all the way outside. And I may have to go outside to show you where this rock ends because this may not even be a rock. This is extraordinary technology. How did they build this 900 years ago in Cambodia? Now, let me show you the walls here. These huge blocks of walls. Look at this block, for example, right? Look at this block. This is going at a 90 degree. This is going at a 90 degree, and that this is fine. But look at here. There is a small bump. Look at this. Okay? Now, this was made to fit this block here. This means that all these blocks were created like a jigsaw puzzle. So that none of them would be easy to pull out. Okay, so this, again, look at here, right? Going all the way here. Look at this piece. There is a small bump here to make this fit. Now, none of the stones, or maybe some of the stones are rectangular or trapezoid, right? But none of these two-dimensional faces have four corners. They have more than four corners. This is extraordinary technology. Each one must weigh, I don't know how many thousands of pounds. And they were able to build this huge jigsaw puzzle 900 years ago. Now, how did they make this? And traditionally, archaeologists and historians will tell, well, they did it out of hard work. They were using chisels and hammers, and they were calculating using threads. Seems impossible to me to make these using chisels and hammers. But I have more evidence. Let's go here. Do you think you can make these with chisels and hammers? Do you think you can make these, now, look at them, they're so dilapidated, right? So they're completely almost on the brink of destruction because of 900 years, and this area, Preah Vihear Temple in Cambodia, is in the Cambodia-Thailand border. War-torn, right? Continuous bombing because of various, you know, political situations. And this Hindu temple dedicated to Lord Shiva has these columns. It's impossible to make them with chisels and hammers. Engineers agree with what I say. These can be created only using lathe technology. They have to have a rotating mechanism, a rotary mechanism to create these type of, you know, turns. Now, let me show you more. Here, look at this column, right? It's a little bit intact and it has a little bit more light. So look at this column, look at these pieces, right? See, these were created
using lathe technology. This proves that ancient builders were using machining technology. So how did they manage to have such an extraordinary rocketing technology about 900 years ago, right? So let's take a look at this rock, for example. It must be weighing more than a ton, and this is one solid piece of rock sitting in Preah Vihear. Now, Preah Vihear temple is situated on top of a mountain which is more than 800 meters high from the ground level, and according to locals, all these rocks were not cut from the mountaintop. They were cut from the ground and then transported here. So how were they able to move massive rocks like this, 800 meters up to the top of the mountain? And here's where mythology comes into place. Because if you look at that carving over there on top, you can see Lord Krishna lifting up a mountain with one hand. Because according to quote-unquote mythology, ancient builders were capable of lifting massive weights. They were able to lift massive rocks like this. And when you look at this carving and then this stone, there is something very interesting. So now look at this carving, which shows how Lord Krishna is able to lift up an entire mountain. And look at this doorway. It's very interesting to see this doorway because we're not able to tell how many pieces are involved in making this doorway. Of course, it's made entirely out of stone. Now look here, we can tell this is one piece. And what about this? Is this a separate column? No, this is one piece. See, there is no joint here. This is all one piece of rock. This seems complex, but let's go on the other side and we may be able to get a better idea. On the other side, we get a better idea. How many pieces are involved in making this massive doorway? Only four. Look at here, this is one piece, and look at this, this is one piece, and then look at this, this is one piece, and then on the top, there's another piece. Make a massive doorway with just four pieces of rock. This requires extraordinary precision. And look, what do you think these cuts are there for? Look on the other side as well. What do you think those are doing? And look carefully. See up top? What do you think these are? Look. These are hinges for the door. Once upon a time, there was a door here. And not just a door made of one solid rock. Imagine how big that rock must have been. So how were they able to do all these kind of extraordinary feats? Did they do it with just simple tools? Let's look at this area, right? And it's very interesting to see if we look at how these are cut and placed. Now look inside. If you look inside, it appears as though they've cut all these solid chunks just like cutting butter. Look at the inside of these separated stones. These stone blocks have separated because of an earthquake. And look inside and you will be able to see the surface of these blocks. Look at how smooth they are. And then there is something else. If you look at here, these are two separate blocks of stone. But look here, you cannot put anything in between. Look at how perfectly fit they are. It's impossible. How did they manage to put all these blocks like this. Look at how perfect the alignment is, even after 900 years. But there's more to the story. It is said that this temple was built by many generations, and the oldest structures were built around 900 AD by a king called Yasovarman. And this part of the temple was said to be built by him. And they say he used a strange technology. I did not believe this until I saw this, but look at this stone. This part of the stone has been destroyed, possibly because of the war between Thailand and Cambodia. But look at this area. There's something very interesting here. What is this? What is this? Is this really sandstone? Look, when I try to scrape off a portion of this, look what's happening. It's easy to scrape this off. Is it possible to do this on sandstone? No, I think this is some kind of geopolymer technology where various types of stones, gravel, sand, etc., were put together and made into huge blocks. Today, we have geopolymer technology where large blocks of stone-like structures are created. Did ancient people create this kind of technology? Is this why we are able to see these bent rock? This place is full of mysteries. The technology involved is unbelievable. Today, we think we are master engineers in the 21st century. But these ancient builders, whoever they were amazing engineers. Just look at these stone steps, for example. These two steps are actually made of one rock. And this is not an exception. We can see stone steps like this all the time, which means what? Look at this step as well. This is not two different blocks. This is one solid piece of stone, and they were able to easily cut it like this. This entire place is full of stones like this. Let's look at these steps, for example. This is the ancient entrance to the Preah Vihear temple. These stone steps were made in the 9th century, about 1,000 years ago. But when I examine them, I'm amazed because what we are looking at is an architectural marvel. Look at these steps and tell me if you see any joints at all. No, these seven steps are made of the same rock. This is hard to fathom, but you may understand this better if you look at the side, protruding outside. Yes, that is also a part of the same rock. And this complex design is not an exception. This seems to be the norm for the ancient builders. Let me show you another one. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven steps made out of one large rock, weighing a lot of tons and perfectly pieced together with the rest of the staircase. And we, the so-called sophisticated visitors, do not even notice this marvel while using these stairs. This means that ancient builders were cutting massive pieces of rocks or using geopolymer technology to make complex shapes. Now, while historians and archaeologists say that these structures were built about 1,000 years ago, some people believe that these structures were made much, much earlier in time. These sound like crazy stories, but there may be evidence of this. Let's go take a look at that carving. Here, you can see a very strange carving. There is a couple sitting on top of an animal. But look at the size of the humans and look at the size of that animal. This animal is almost the size of an elephant, of a modern-day elephant. But you can tell it's not an elephant. It almost looks like a massive cat-like animal. This is definitely a prehistoric animal. And Hinduism, in Hindu temples, in India and other countries, there are carvings of extinct prehistoric animals like the saber-toothed tiger. Was this temple really built 1,000 years ago? Or was it built during prehistoric times? There is something very mysterious about Preah Vihear, this temple dedicated to Lord Shiva in Cambodia. And we're going to see more in the next video soon. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Bye.